Imagine the Earth as a newborn baby planet, naked, steaming, and bawling with fire-spewing volcanoes. An angry infant still suffering growing pains from its violent birth 4.5 billion years ago. The planet is practically glowing from the heat, bombarded by meteorites big enough to wipe out cities. Definitely not somewhere you'd choose to vacation. Around 3.5 billion years ago, the planet began to stabilize and cool. Volcanic activity started to decline. The skies cleared of dust and gas. And as steam condensed out of the early atmosphere, rain fell for millions of years, filling the basins with water and creating the first oceans. Though still battered by meteorites and racked by the occasional megavolcano, Earth was becoming downright hospitable compared to its early hellish conditions. The stage was set for life to begin. But how did the first living organisms arise on this once desolate world? There are a few leading theories. One suggests that the chemical precursors of life first came together around hydrothermal vents deep in the newly formed oceans. These vents spewed out superheated mineral-rich water loaded with gases like hydrogen, methane, and hydrogen sulfide. When this vent water interfaced with the cold surrounding seabed, its chemistry changed drastically, driving the formation of complex organic compounds. Experiments have shown that amino acids, which are the essential building blocks of proteins and life, can form spontaneously in vent-like environments. Over hundreds of millions of years, more complex chemistry led to the assembly of the first primitive proteins, RNA, and ultimately the earliest single-celled organisms. A second hypothesis proposes that life began not in the oceans, but in warm, mineral-rich pools and puddles on the terrestrial landscape. The wetting and drying cycles in these puddles, driven by daily heating and cooling, and by seasonal rains and droughts, promoted a rich chemical environment that encouraged reactions between simple compounds. UV radiation and lightning strikes provided additional energy. Experiments show such conditions can produce amino acids, lipids, and nucleobases like cytosine and uracil, all critical biological molecules. Clays and other minerals in the puddles may have provided a matrix upon which chemicals concentrated and reacted to form larger, more complex structures. A third possibility is that life originated in the ancient oceans themselves. Even once the late heavy bombardment ended around 4 billion years ago, meteorites and comets continued to deliver a steady rain of organic molecules to early Earth. Meanwhile, sunlight-driven chemistry was producing additional compounds in the oceans and atmosphere. Over hundreds of millions of years, the seas became rich primordial soups of organic chemicals. At some point, the concentrations grew high enough for self-replicating molecules like RNA to emerge through a cascade of ever more intricate reactions. Lipid molecules may have then self-assembled into vesicles with membranes, creating bubble-like enclosures that led to the first protocells. Of course, no one yet knows which of these scenarios is most accurate, or if life actually began through some totally different process still unknown to us. But there is little doubt that by 3 billion years ago, life had taken hold on our once desolate planet. The earliest evidence of life comes in the form of chemical traces from 3.5 billion year old rocks in Western Australia. By 2.5 billion years ago, microbial fossils become abundant and widespread. From those humble beginnings, life expanded and diversified into the incredible myriad of forms we see today, from majestic redwood trees to intricate corals to soaring eagles. And of course, humanity with our cities, technologies, and pondering of life's origins. All can trace their roots back to a time when conditions on our planet were just right to spark that first instance of biological organization and complexity that kicked off this epic story.